Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Now, it's time to say hello to Father Robert Ballasser. He is, of course, the digital Jesuit and the host of Coding 101, Know-How, This Week in Enterprise Tech on the Twit Network. And he loves his Acers. We gave him the latest Acer convertible for this review.
You want a laptop, but it has to be light. And you want a touchscreen, but you need a keyboard. And you want Windows. No, real Windows. And you don't want to spend more than $390. That, in a nutshell, is who should look at the Acer Aspire Switch 10 Windows 8 notebook. Our review model was the Switch 10 SW5-11, featuring a 10.1-inch 1366x768 IPS screen with 5-point multi-touch. The screen is driven by a quad-core Intel Atom Z3745 Bay Trail processor running at 1.33 GHz, supported by 2 GB of system memory and a 64 GB SSD. The Switch 10 is a hybrid device, with a detachable screen that connects to its base with a set of clever friction latches and powerful magnets. Hold down the keyboard base and gently pull upwards, and the screen can act as a standalone Windows 8 tablet. Put it back, and it's a traditional notebook. Flip the screen around, and it can tuck the keyboard behind itself. Lift the screen, and it acts as a presentation display. Flip it over, and you're now in tent mode. The Switch 10 is a small and light device. It measures 10.25 inches by 7 inches by 0.35 inches thick and 1.2 pounds heavy, or 2.2 pounds with the keyboard. On the left side of the Switch 10, you'll find a combo audio port, power switch, and volume rocker. On the right side, a micro SD card reader, micro USB port, micro HDMI, and the power port. The right side of the keyboard adds a USB 2.0 port, and along the hinges of the Switch 10 are tucked a set of surprisingly powerful stereo speakers and a Windows 8 action key. For connectivity, the Switch 10 has a dual-band 802.11 ABGN wireless card with Bluetooth 4.0. So that's the tech. The question is, how does it work? As a Windows 8.1 tablet, the Switch 10 is actually great for the price. It handled YouTube, Netflix, and typical web surfing without a hitch. The screen has rich color and deep blacks, though, at times, I wish there was an easy way to turn down the sensitivity on screen rotation so the Switch 10 wasn't always changing orientation. But performance was snappy, and the brushed aluminum backing felt good in my hands. As a laptop, well, it's a mixed bag. Acer includes the Office Home 2013 suite, which makes the Switch 10 ideal for students or those who want a basic email word processing surfing machine. In PC Mark 8, the Switch 10 scored 1,232. Not a great score, but still enough to do most everything that the average user will want to do. The keyboard base is well designed. Unlike other hybrid notebook/tablets, there's enough weight at the front of the base to keep the Switch 10 from constantly turning turtle whenever your hands leave the keyboard. Also helping is the fact that the design makes the back of the base rise when the screen is opened, helping to keep the notebook stable. I wasn't a big fan of the keyboard and trackpad. They're usable, but seemed to constantly remind me that I'm working on a budget machine. The keys are cramped, which is to be expected, and mushy, which was not expected. The trackpad is just about average. The 2-cell lithium poly battery is rated for 8 hours of use, but as always, it depends on how you use the notebook. Streaming Netflix over the wireless connection, I killed the battery in just under 5 hours. Surfing the web, I averaged 9 hours. And using the Switch 10 on and off for reference and occasional Twitter trolling, I could go a week without charging. The Acer Aspire Switch 10 is available now for between $300 and $400.
Well, I have to say, I love my Acer Aspire S7. You recommended that. Mary Jo Foley also bought one. We both think they're great laptops, but those are full-size Windows 8 laptops. This is a little smaller and a little bit different. Pros and cons on the Acer Aspire Switch 10.
Well, the pros is I like the flexibility. I mean, the ability to use tent mode or to, you know, take
Show me that tent mode.
Okay, well, so this is tent mode. So I take this tablet, I take off the screen.
Whoa!
I flip this thing around.
Wow!
Like so. and then I do this.
Yeah.
And it will readjust the screen. So, like, if you're on a plane.
If we got some spooky stories, we could get in the tent.
Absolutely.
No, I'm sorry.
Well, there's, like, four different modes. There's
notebook mode. That's for watching movies.
Tablet mode. Yep. Right, right. It's nice to have that in such a low price point product.
Right.
The other thing I like about it is the price. I mean, $300 to $400, this really is a sort of a back-to-school special, something that you can have that's pretty decently powered for the price, and yet you're not worried about destroying it.
I have to say, it's netbook price, but it feels better than a netbook. It feels pretty solid, nice-looking screen.
And it's far more stable than the other convertibles. So my favorite has been the ASUS Transformer.
Yeah.
It's a tablet that you can put onto a laptop docking station. But unlike the Transformer, this thing will actually stay up on the base. The base is weighted enough in the front that you can get down to like 60, 75 degrees before it starts to tip back.
It actually feels like a solid laptop.
Yeah, yeah. Now, on the cons, it's a $400, $300 device, so you're going to have some build issues. The biggest thing is the keyboard and the trackpad. It's substandard. I mean, let me be honest about that. If you're typing a lot, you're probably going to want to get an external keyboard just because it's so mushy.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want something that could be a tablet and at the same time can be a full-featured Windows 8 device, like, for example, I'm running my Channelizer on this. This is a
show this, Chad. This is kind of cool.
This is a program.
So you're using it as a tablet.
Right. I'm using it as a tablet, but right now it's showing me all of the RF energy inside the Brick House Studio. This is something you cannot do on a tablet. You need a laptop to do this. But because this runs full Windows 8, it's going to be able to run software like this, and that's always a good thing.
So pros, it's nice for the price, but cons, it's as with anything at that price, it's got a little there's some sacrifices.
Exactly.
Would you buy it? Try it.
I would actually give this a buy. If you compare this to something like the Acer S7, you're going to be disappointed. But the Acer S7 is four times more.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So if you are looking for something, say, back to school for a student, if you want full Windows 8, not some funky Windows RT device.
This is pretty good.
This is a buy.
Now, you said Acer was getting out of the low-end market. Are they going to abandon this, or is this something they want to keep around?
I think this is a differentiated device. So they want to go high-end for the devices like laptops, where you can have something elegant.
Right.
But this is a niche product, and they kind of like niche.
I like it.
I think they'll stay with
it. At Chromebook prices, but Windows 8 features.
Absolutely.
I think that's a pretty good deal. Thank you. Father Robert Ballester, the host of This Week in Enterprise Tech, Know-How and Coding 101. He does a lot of work for us, and we're really glad you're here and part of our Brick House studio.